हेलो एवरीवन, वी आर हियर अगेन फॉर फाइनल एंटेलमेंट मेथड पार्ट 6। इन अर्लियर 5 लेक्चर्स और 5 पार्ट्स वी वर डिस्कसिंग अबाउट इन पार्ट 1 द बेसिक स्टेप्स और बेसिक 9 स्टेप्स इन फाइनल एंटेलमेंट एनालिसिस। देन पार्ट 2 वी डिस्कस्ड अबाउट द फॉर्मिंग द ग्लोबल स्टिफनेस मैट्रिक्स। इन पार्ट 3 वी वर डिस्कसिंग अबाउट अप्लाइंग द बाउंड्री कंडीशन फॉर स्पेशली स्ट्रक्चरल प्रॉब्लम। पार्ट 4 we were discussing about applying the boundary condition for heat transfer problem, and part 5 we were discussing about the node numbering and finding out the orientation of each and every element for plane truss problem. Now in part 6 what we are going to cover is common mistakes in finite element method by students. This is 6 common mistakes which I have found out while delivering the lectures and taking examination for finite element course. So what are these 5 basically 6 most mistakes, and I'll also give some recommendation and how to eliminate these particular common mistakes, because if you are going to solve finite element method or for any class of problem, you are going to follow certain steps, and there are many steps. So generally students forget some step or bypass or present one step which need to be followed at step number 3, they follow at step number 5. So what are these? We will explain in details. Step number 1 is bypassing the step. Step 2, discretization and element numbering. Step 3, distorted stiffness matrix error. 4th, applying boundary condition on kg only, then directly presenting the final results, then solving only the half part of the question. What is mistake number 1? Bypassing these steps. Bypassing this step means while solving any problem, let it be this particular simple beam problem, you need to follow 9 steps. What were those steps? Firstly, discretize the element, perform the node element numbering, then node numbering, then find out the local stiffness matrix for each element, then assemblies of those stiffness matrices, then find out the nodal displacement vector, then find out the external force vector, then assemble those 3 parameter K, U and F on that particular formula that called K U is equal to F, this would be capital F. After that, applying the boundary condition, then once you have applied boundary condition, some rows and column was reduced, so representing that reduced matrix, then converting into those matrices into the equivalent simultaneous equation, and applying approaches like Gauss elimination, Cramer's rules to solve those particular problem, and then finally find out the step, especially the nodal displacement at each and every node. After that, if a question asks, then about finding out the secondary variables. So clue is that while performing or solving any class of problem, may it be structural, thermal or heat, you need to follow those 9 steps sequentially, because you are using a particular method and method has steps. You are going to bypass any step, in that case your marking or your solution or the particular variable which you are going to calculate at the end, that is not going to be original one, and if that is not going to original one, it means that you have solved that particular class of problem using wrong steps. So you need to make sure that you are exactly following 9 steps. Then what is error number 2? It says discretization and element numbering error. It means that if any problem is given, generally student what they do, that they discretize this particular element on random basis. For example, they discretize this element as only one element, or some student what they do, they element 1, element 2 and element 3. They solve or they discretize on basis of these either only single element or 3 element. Their understanding is that if they have discretized, that they have completed step number 1, but that is incorrect. if you are going to discretize this particular element, then you need to take care that the external force in this particular case is applying at middle of this particular beam. So you need to locate at least one node at a point of application of force. Otherwise, this particular force value is not being considered into your this particular vector, global force vector. If it's not being considered, that it means then your particular solution for this particular problem, especially beam, is incorrect. Secondary, while solving the heat transfer problem, generally they discretize into only one or two element and they try to figure it out the temperature, because especially in heat transfer problem, a particular cylinder or bar is given, left end is maintained at a particular temperature, right end is either maintained at a particular temperature or it is in contact with the flowing fluid. Now if heat is supplying from left end, your objective is to find out the distribution of temperature at any intermediate point. So if you are going to find out intermediate temperature at any particular point, then you need to discretize as many number up as possible. Generally, it's recommended that for solving the heat transfer problem, you need to discretize minimum for 4 element. Because if you are going to discretize for 4 element, in that case, error would be minimum and you can at least locate 2 intermediate point. If you are going to locate 2 intermediate point, because one is left end, one is right end, and you have located 2 intermediate point, it means that chances of error is very minimum. So for discretization and element numeric error, clue is always locate a particular point on the point of application of external force. For structural problem, for heat transfer problem, at least discretize your particular domain into minimum 4 component, then it is going to be correct, or at least close to the exact solution or approximate solution. Then error number 3, distorted stiffness matrix. Distorted stiffness matrix means for this particular problem, you need to, for example, we had one node. Element 1, element 2. Now node numbering, element node number 1, node number 2, node number 3. Now I need to find out what K1, K2, this is K1 for locus stiffness matrix for element 1, element 2. Every time you will be having some value EI by L cube, then this particular matrix. Then again EI by L cube, then this particular matrix. What generally students do that if these parameters, especially the length of this particular element, this element of this particular element is say uniform or exactly same, in that case this EI by L cube is common for both element. But in another case, if your this location of this particular point, in this case the length of element 1 is suppose 1 meter and length of element 2 is 2 meter, the stiffness matrix K1 and K2 will be going to be exactly or very much different, because the value of L is 1 for first element and this is 2 for element number 2. It means that while assembling the local stiffness matrix into global sense, what you are doing that you are exactly exporting each and every element from this local matrix to the global. It means you need to consider this particular value. Why? Because this particular EI by L cube is common for each and every element. It means if you are taking this particular element from this location to the global stiffness matrix, you need to multiply every element of this particular square matrix with this constant, that then import to that particular value. Okay, so this is error number 3. You make sure that you are each and every time you are multiplying the constant or EI by L cube with each and every member of stiffness matrix, especially local stiffness matrix, while assembling or forming the global stiffness matrix. Now error number 4. Error number 4 is applying boundary condition on KZ only. This is in direct relation with error number 1. That says bypassing this step. Bypassing the steps means you are not exactly following 9 steps, but you are following 5, 4 or 3 steps. Many times students like solve particular problem using 3 steps only. They are like, their process is correct, their solution is also correct, anyhow, but they are not representing that how they come to this particular solution. If you have not, you are not able to present that how you have gone from step number 1 to 9, then you will not going to get say more than 50% of that marks, because you are using finite element method, and method has certain steps. You need to show that how you have come across that. This is the common issue. They have formed the global stiffness matrix K global, and then applied the boundary condition on that particular global stiffness matrix. But in reality, we have already discussed that you need to formulate this equation K global, then this is square matrix K global, then load displacement vector, then F. Once you have formulated this matrix, now you are applying boundary condition on this particular matrix. How? Boundary means the element or node which are fixed. You are able to figure it out only on element or say column vector U, because U is 0 for a particular element. Why 0? Because that point is either fixed or any other case. So you, if you are having, for example, you are having a simple bar, okay, let's suppose this is a beam, you are applying a particular load this particular point. In that case, if this is element 1, element 2, element 3, this is simple bar, in that case your size will be 6 cross 6, you will be 6 cross 1 and 6 cross 1. Why 6? Because it is beam, and beam has degree of freedom 2 at every node. One is displacement, vertical displacement, and one is rotation term, V and theta. It means 2 at this point, 2 at this point, 2 at this point. It means total 6. I mean your matrix is 6 cross 6. How to apply boundary condition? One is fixed. It means now you need to remove element, so row number 1 and row number 2, corresponding column number 1 and column number 2. Why? Because this is unknown variable. This is V1, this is theta 1. If it is fixed, then its value is 0 and 0. Because we know the value of V1 and theta 1 is 0, that is why we are eliminating row number 1 and 2 and row column number 1 and 2. Not because it's already understood that the element number 1 fixed, that is why we have removed the particular element from global stiffness matrix. So always take care that you need to apply only the boundary condition after you have expressed this equation, where K is global stiffness matrix, U is nodal displacement, and F is global force vector. Now, error number 5. Error number 5 says directly presenting the final results. Till now, you have applied the boundary condition. Once you have applied boundary condition in this case, 6 cross 6, 6 cross 1, 6 cross 1. You have removed 2 rows, 2 column. It means your reduced matrix is 4 cross 2, 4, 4 cross 4. If your matrix is 4 cross 4, 4 cross 4, let me write over there. Four cross four means 4 cross 4 is square matrix, then 4 cross 1 and 4 cross 1. Now you need to present this particular matrix into the reduced form, then you need to apply these method, either Gauss elimination approach or Cramer's rules or any other method which you know to solve any algebraic equation. Because once you have formulated this square matrix, column vector, multiply this square matrix with this column vector, equate with that particular rows, you will get first equation, then second equation, third equation, and fourth equation. There would be 1, 2, 3, 4, this. 4 equation. It means 4 equation, 4 unknown. To solve 4 equation, 4 unknown, you have this method. You need to explain that how you have performed 4 equation, 4 unknown operation. Otherwise, you are again, if you have formulated this equation, this format, and then directly presenting the result, you have bypassed these steps. Bypass this step, it means you have not followed this step, and your marks will be directly reduced to 50% or 60%. Then error number 6. Error number 6, that solving only the half part of the question. Many times in question is already given that you need to find out at least one primary variable, then secondary variable. Primary variables means, for heat transfer problem, primary variable is nodal temperature at intermediate node. For structural problem, the primary variable is finding out the displacement at each and every node. The secondary variables are like for heat transfer, for a structural problem, finding out the elemental stresses and finding out the reaction force. For structural heat transfer problem, finding out the heat flow rate at entry and exit or any other point. So always try to or make sure that you are reading the question in full sense. Full sense means always try to figure it out at the initial or very first stage of this for solving the FEM problem, that whether it is asking only the primary variable or secondary variable too. Because if it is asking primary variables, for example, if your question is 15 marks, it is asking that find out the global displacement, sigma and the action force. It means that you are going to get 10 marks for solving this particular problem. Then 2 marks or 2.5 marks for this and 2.5 marks for this. If you have solved only U, it means maximum marks you are going to obtain out of 10, not 15. So do not repeat this mistake. Or how to mitigate is that only make sure that you are reading the question in flow, full. Now at the end, in summary, these are the 6 common mistakes which majority of students, I would say around in a class of 190 or 192, I have come across that at least more than 80 students, around 50% making mistakes, either any one of these mistakes or more than one. So bypassing this step, solution is follow all those 9 steps. Discretization and element numbering error, always make sure that you are taking at least 4 elements for heat transfer problem, and always consider a node at a point of application of force. In distorted stiffness matrix error, solution is that while forming the global stiffness matrix, always take or multiply this constant value for each and every element, then export it to global stiffness matrix. For applying boundary condition on kg only, do not repeat this mistake, because you cannot apply boundary condition on k global. You need to apply boundary condition on this ku is equal to f, where u is unknown. You are only solving where u is equal to 0, you are eliminating this rows column. For directly presenting final results, for say to mitigate this particular error, always explain that how you have come across this 4 equation, 4 unknown in equation form. Then you need to explain which particular method you have used. At least you need to mention, give at least 3 or 4 steps, then present your results. At the end, solving only the half part of the question, it's very important, because it's very common that generally you see the majority of questions only U is you need to find U only or primary variable, and for heat transfer only T. But make sure that whether it is asking for secondary variable or not. If it is asking for secondary variable, make sure the, you have computed all those particular primary and secondary variables. In this way, starting from lecture 1, 2, 3, 4, 5 and common mistakes part 6, I hope that you would be able to solve simpler problem either in plane truss, beam, spring, or combination of beam and spring, or heat transfer, especially in one dimension, either only conduction or heat transfer, conduction plus conduction. At the end, wish you all the very best for your final examination. Thank you.